Hello everyone and welcome back to Billis and Bareback Equestrian. My name is Mackenzie Wild and welcome to our channel. Today's YouTube video is going to be quite interesting as Freedom had her little foal and we're having quite a bit of complications. So unfortunately, the foal is having trouble finding the teat to nurse and is trying to suckle way too high, and he's pretty weak and kind of needs that colostrum. So we're gonna try putting honey on the teat so that he can start suckling in the right spot. So we ended up going to get a colostrum supplement from Tractor Supply as he really, really needs that. And we were able to get a little bit of that in him through the bottle. And so now we're kind of just gonna like keep on waiting and hope that he latches on. The most important part is we got a little bit of that colostrum in him. And so now we just keep on waiting and keep on trying. Unfortunately, things are not looking good as the foal is about 5-6 hours old now and is still unable to successfully suckle. Once again, still can't find the right spot. So I have a friend coming because we are in crunch time, and if we don't act on this now, unfortunately the foal will likely not make it. So I have a friend on her way and she is coming with a trailer, and we are going to have to go take them to a vet way out of here because unfortunately the two vets in our area do not take on this type of stuff. So that is our next steps to try and save this little colt's life. We are currently on our way to the vet. I am following behind my friend who is driving the trailer. We unfortunately have an hour and a half drive to get there, and baby is getting worse by the minute, so we are gonna keep hoping that we can save this poor boy right now. Life is never dull. So we have successfully made it to the vet's office, and my friends are about 5 minutes out. These next three updates I filmed in my car on the way home because I unfortunately am a bit shy regarding vlogging and filming YouTube videos in front of other people. There we go. Upon getting to the vet and in their initial examination, they discovered, first off, what we kind of already knew about baby, that baby had not eaten nearly as much as she should have, and we needed to get something in him quick. They also discovered that Freedom had not released or dropped, or whatever the proper term for it, my brain is currently fried, as much placenta as she should have by that hour, because the placenta typically expels 3 hours after birth, and so it was very obvious that that had not come out all the way, and that was what we discovered upon the initial examination. After a while of trying, we were finally able to get baby to suckle. So that's good because he started getting that colostrum and that food in him that he needed. We also ended up giving him a plasma treatment as well as some fluids. As he did need them, he was dehydrated and definitely not where he should have been. However, after the plasma and the fluids, he was definitely doing a lot better. Freedom, however, was a different story and a lot more serious. Because she had not released all of her placenta and she still had a good amount of it inside of her, they had to do a procedure in order to get it all out, because if that placenta doesn't all come out, that increases the chances of founder, laminitis, and could even cause death. So they ended up doing that procedure and we finally got all of that placenta out. This they did an ultrasound on baby, as baby had yet to urinate, and they wanted to make sure that there was not something deeper going on behind the scenes. They did not find anything, however that's one of the biggest reasons they wanted to keep baby overnight, is because he had not urinated. Regarding Freedom, they wanted to keep her overnight because she had a fever that kept going up and down and up and down, and due to her medical issues and being that they were a lot more severe than baby, decided it was best for both of them to just stay overnight for observation. To say it has been a stressful day is an understatement. With that being said, we have started a fundraiser and are trying to raise money and gather donations so that we can continue to help make sure these guys go on to live a happy, healthy life, right?
So I'm going to put the link to the Facebook fundraiser in our description on the bottom. So definitely check there. Our PayPal is up here. Our Venmo's right here. Our Zelle is right here. Any donation counts. Every single penny, it makes a huge difference and it will save these horses' lives. Vets are not very cheap, unfortunately, so anything you feel inclined to do is very much appreciated. We will also be sending thank you cards to everyone who donates. With that being said, even if you cannot donate, like this video, share this video, share any of the posts on the fundraiser, share our donation links. Any of that helps just as much, because the more you share it, the more you like it, the more you show other people, the more likely we are to get donations from people who actually can. But anyway, we appreciate each and every one of you. Check back in tomorrow, as we will probably be doing a second vlog of trying to keep these guys alive, bringing them home potentially, I hope. So yeah, but in the meantime, don't forget to hit the red subscribe button. Check us out on Facebook, Instagram. Check out the fundraiser link, which is in the bio. We hope you all have a fantastic, amazing, and wonderful evening, and catch y'all later.